This week on New Media Tech, I'm going to show you an iOS app that allows you to do podcasting right from your iPhone or your iPad. Coming up. It's time for another episode of New Media Tech, and this week we are not live, and I will tell you why we're not live. Actually, we're not really live anytime right now, but I'm actually on vacation. As you're watching this, I'm somewhere nice and warm, or I hope it's warm. That's what I'm going there for, making sure it's warm. And you're going to see some things a little different. You see behind me, we're working on the studio, on Studio A, and we're actually working a little bit on Studio B as well. But what I've done is I've pre-recorded a couple things that I want to do the next couple of weeks while I'm gone. And then when I get back, actually, while I'm gone, I think I'm going to start recording the intro to netcasting thing that I mentioned last week. And so when I come back, I'll be able to put that up. But this week, I've done two things. I've already done them, so I'm basically going to cut over to them. These episodes are probably a little bit shorter. I don't remember how long each one of them is. But I have two products that I kind of walked through this past weekend. Both of them are iPad-based apps that I want to show you, or I will say one of them is iOS. It's iPad and iPhone both. Actually, BossJock works on both too, so it's an iOS type thing. And actually, I'll show you BossJock on both. But this week, I'm going to show you an application called BossJock. And if you are wanting to get into podcasting fairly inexpensively and something just to try to see how it works, which is what I always recommend you do, don't start out big. Don't go all off the deep end and buying all the stuff until you see how it's going to work for you and if you'd like to do it. And if you get past episode 10 or so and you still like doing it, then maybe you can start, you know, spending a little bit more money on it. And the app, I can't remember what it is. I think it's either $9 or $19. One of them, I have two different apps. So I can't remember which one was which. But it's an app designed for creating podcasts. There are some problems with it, and I will walk through that. But as starting out, if you can ignore the issues that you have with it, then I think you'll be fine. So right now I'm going to cut over to what I already pre-recorded. Hi, I'm Mike Myers, and I'm the host of the New Media Show, and I'm actually on my day off in the studio, actually working on my day off, really. You see behind me we're putting up some new studio stuff, but I'm kind of taking a break, and I was playing with some things that I've heard of recently, and I wanted to do a little show and tell to include us in a future episode. I'm sorry I'm not dressed in my normal black logo shirt and stuff, but this is, like I said, normally my day off. So what I want to show you is an iPad. Well, I think it actually, let me mute this before I hurt everybody's ears so I get it where it needs to go. I actually think that it works on the iPhone too. Do you have my iPhone? I'll check it out real quick just to see. But for some reason, I think it works on the iPhone. I've only played with it on the iPad. But basically, if you're a podcaster or getting into podcasting and you have an iPad, let me see if it's on my iPhone and if it runs. And if it does, if you have an iPhone, you can very easily get in to start doing some podcasting stuff. Yeah, it's actually on my iPhone too. Audio is muted. Okay, so I can show it to you on the iPhone as well. And does it only work in that one direction? It only works one direction. Okay, well, I'll show you that too, since I have it here. I don't have anything in my playlist, and actually I don't have anything good really in this playlist either. But you see my iPad plugged in to so we can listen. And basically, it's an okay app. I will tell you the thing that I don't like about it is it's using the built-in microphone on the iPad, and we haven't really gotten into great detail yet, depending on our air list, about microphones and types. But it's not the greatest sound. Although, if you're getting into it, if you're in a quiet room, it would be fine for starting out. But I wouldn't think you'd want to use it for long term. Now, there may be a way to get a microphone into it. I haven't figured that out because the actual output is using the plug where you would normally plug in a microphone. There is the possibility of plugging one in the other end. Maybe one of the Korg adaptors or the Alesis adapters that go on the bottom might work and get audio in. I haven't tried that yet. I don't have anything that works with an iPad, but I do have something that works with an iPhone. So I may actually try that with the iPhone and come back and tell you what the results were. Because I have an Alesis box that plugs in the bottom of my iPhone that I can record directly to the iPhone audio. And I'm wondering if it takes input from that for microphone. I'll try that out and I'll maybe just update you when I put this in, on the air. So what I want to do is I want to, let me get back into sending out this to, oh, I'm going to be able to hear it when I do this. Well, we'll see. So I'm going to show you what it looks like on the screen. Let me get back out of this. So this is, it's called BossJock. And I can't remember what it was. I think like $19 or something like that in the app store. But what you see here is you see basically a bunch of carts that are over in the left. And then on the right, you see a slider when it has mix, and then it has mic volume control, and then cart volume control. And down at the bottom, you see this little button that you push when you want to talk. And if you want to keep talking, left-hand side, there's a little lock button right there. And that will keep it pushed down. And you see when it's down, you see the bars moving up and down, simulating a VU meter. Let me just tell you, though, don't trust them for any kind of meter. Not even close. Because you see right now they're not even going down when there's no noise, and I'm in a room that's made of foam, so with foam all around it. So it should be very, very quiet, and it's not definitely a good representation of it. So I just turned off the talk. So when you're playing something, like I'm gonna play this right now, and you can at this point I'm not talking, but this is playing. Let me see if I actually get. Am I going to the? Yeah, so I'm not going to let you hear it because when I put it into AirPlay mode, I'll actually do a little bit without being in AirPlay mode, but I'm actually showing this through an Apple TV AirPlay, so with all the sounds going to the Apple TV, and that's not into my system here. But anyways, right now it's playing one cart, and you can adjust the cart. You see over here on the right, the cart volume is adjustable, and then if I hit the button to talk, you'll see that the meters do drop down a little bit. However, what happens is it's ducking the audio so you can talk on top of it. And you can play more than one cart at a time. Like I have three things in here in the cart and I can play them all three at one time. Yeah, you can stop them just by hitting them. And so it's, you know, pretty easy to use. Like again, the quality of the microphone is my biggest issue with it. To go into record, if I hit record and I'm going to, you see up top it says slide the pause. So basically right now I'm in record mode. You see the counter going. I'm going to do a little bit of a Jackson 5 here. And I'm going to record this and stick it out with this. But as I'm talking, so there, I'm starting to talk myself, so it should have ducked the audio. And now I'll bring the audio back up. So let me stop this. I'm going to stop the recording. And let's go in and look at some of the settings. And you see you have ducking amount. Like I have, it came with 75% by default. About 85% I think is about right, for at least for what I've been playing with it. I also made the attack and the release a little bit longer because it was like, it was almost like instant. So it's still, you know, half a second to take the ducking down and 8/10, almost 9/10 of a second to release the ducking. And then you have the cart fades. I increased that as well because it seemed like it cut it off a little quick. And you can see you have low cut filters and buffers and things like that as well. And then the other thing they've added in here is the ability to do show notes. So we use Google Docs for all of our show notes. But if you're just starting out and you want to just do it on the iPad, there you go. It's right there in the show notes. You can put your show notes right in there. So I haven't actually put show notes in here, but you can see you double click and you edit it. There's no real easy way to send things in from the outside. So most of my notes I do is I either do them in Evernote or Google Docs, and eventually make it in the Google Docs. Using ifttt.com, I do transfer things into Google Docs kind of automatically. I want to read articles and stuff, so it's real easy to get in there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn off AirPlay. So let me go back over here to me, turn off AirPlay, and then we'll play with this a little bit. So now you're back over to me, and let me go turn off AirPlay so that we can actually hear it. All right, now we should be back over to hear it. So let's see, let's make sure I just get on my notes and make sure I actually have audio running. And I do. So we're going to do this now. Here's one of the things that I found about this that was rather annoying. Ultimately, you can get used to this, but the delay of processing in this is slow enough that when you talk in your ears, like I'm listening to headphones right now, and I'm not sure how you're going to hear it in the recording. Hopefully, you're hearing it the way you hear it out of this, but it's so slow that you actually hear an echo of your voice. So it's not real bad. It just sounds like you got a lot of reverb on something. It's not like you're in a stadium where you're hearing a major delay of sound, but it's enough that it's noticeable and a little bit annoying. So I'm going to go ahead and turn on the iPad. So now the iPad is on. I'm going to go ahead and hit the button. I'm going to talk, and we'll see if we can get the echo effect or not. All right. So now I am – yeah, you hear the echo effect really good in my ears at least. Now I am hitting the button, and I'm talking. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and start up the Jackson 5. And when I hit the button like that, it drops the audio, ducks the audio down. And when I let off the button, so now it's locked down, so my hands are free and I'm talking, and hopefully you're hearing the echo. This is what you're going to hear when you talk because of the delay, because your jaw is transmitting your inner ear sound, and it's getting back to your ears a little bit later and just causes this weird reverby effect. So that's all that is. Now, as I'm playing and talking, I'm right now on the mic volume control, so I can increase my mic volume. I can also go over to cart and just as easily increase the cart volume, or lower it the way down. So adjustment there. And then there's also a total mix, which is like basically this huge mix together. And you see me getting louder and the music getting louder. So that's the mix volume. And in the meantime, I can take and I can hit another song and switch over just like that. So let's go back over to ABC and we're gonna start and stop the song. So now we're back at ABC again. The problem is this is an issue maybe, I don't know. It depends on how you look at it. It doesn't start back up where you left off, which in most cases I think that's probably good. But I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to stop the background. And you see it kind of fades out. So I'm going to go ahead and turn off this mic. So that's it's a little quick drop off there. But, I mean, for what it does, it's pretty cool. Even if you just used it to play back things like Soundboard. This is cheaper than Soundboard, I think. I don't know what Soundboard costs on the iPad. I can't remember. But, Soundboard for the PC or the Mac is like $49. Now, like in the case here, we do run Soundboard we run on all kinds of things. We run a Soundboard on iPads. I typically have it running on the computer in the other room, in the control room, and I have Soundboard remote if I'm going to run sounds. So I basically still runs on the computer or next to the soundboard. So I don't got to run a cable like this, because you hear as I'm moving us around, it's crackling a little bit like that. Sorry, I didn't mean hurt your ears. But yeah, that's the kind of thing I try to avoid. And in there, it's all hardwired, so I just do Soundboard remote. But this is kind of a cool idea. I played with it with just my in-ears in yesterday a little bit. And I think this would be a cool thing to tell people about. It's an inexpensive way to get started. And, you know, we're talking about starting from scratch if you just want to bring up a podcast. So what I do want to do is, first of all, let me mute this. I'm going to set it down. It's going to start crackling again. I will bring up my iPhone. I haven't played with the iPhone app yet, but it looks very similar, just a little bit smaller. So let me bring it up and let me put that up on the screen. All right, so let's see. Now you're going to see my iPhone. And let me get back to BossJock. Now, I have no music in here. Actually, I can add music. If you click on the empty one, it'll let me pick from a music library, which I'm not quite sure what I have on here. You can see it actually picks up from iTunes, Dropbox, anything kind of recording you can have on your phone or whatever. So I'm going to go to music library. I don't put a lot of music. Oh, there's ABC. We'll just use it. My iPhone doesn't have a lot of music on it. I typically use my iPad for that mostly. All right, so basically it's really similar. It's small. Here's their settings down here instead of being at the top. And you can see it's the defaults. So like I said, I made this 85% or about. And I increased the tack to a little bit over half a second. And then the release to almost 9/10 of a second. And then I increased the fade time to about a second and a half. Just like that. But okay, so I have 8 carts, 15 carts. Oh, I guess I can change. I didn't know I could do that. Oh, they got smaller, so you can do different size carts. I don't know how many carts you can do on the iPad. Well, you can do 20 or 35 carts on the iPad, so you can increase that iPad too. But again, there is a ABC playing, but you're not gonna be able to hear it. And then I would be ducking the audio at this point. As I'm holding the button down, and there's also a lock here on the left-hand side. You might be able to see it over here, the very left of the microphone, the lock that holds it down by itself. So yeah, it works decent on the iPhone too. So if you have an iPhone, you could start podcasting with this. Again, I don't know what the microphone quality would, but I'm sure it'd be exactly the same with this. As actually, we can do this. We can take the cord. Let me turn off broadcast to do this, but take the cord and stick it into my iPhone, just like that, and I'm going to guess the echo is exactly the same. What I'm going to do is turn off. AirPlay, so I'm going to go to headphones, just like that. It kind of did it on its own, didn't it? All right, well, that's good, and I'm going to go back over so you're not staring at the Apple TV, and let's hit the button here. Let's make sure I got audio going back and forth. Before I unmute it, so don't kill anybody's ears. Oh, I'm getting a lot of audio back, actually. I would have hurt somebody's ears doing that. Because it's still playing ABC. That's why. So. All right, so we're going to unmute it. And we're going to hit record to talk. So
now I'm talking, and yeah, it's still kind of loud, but you can kind of, that helps some. You can see it still has the echo, so that problem's going to exist. It's not as bad, though, I think, on here. I don't know if maybe the faster processor in my iPhone 5 is the reason, but it's not quite as bad. So you're going to get a little bit of delay. So you just as long as you can deal with that, this isn't a bad option as long as you can get somewhere that's quiet. It's going to hear everything, and you hear in the background, when I'm pushing that down, you hear a fan running, and I'm 2 rooms away from here. And that's just because it's a very sensitive microphone. That's just the way the iPhones and anything are. It's the only problem. If you're comparing it to a microphone, you want to compare it to kind of what a condenser mic would sound like, a very omnidirectional condenser mic as well. But that is a very quick review of
BossJock. So let me go ahead and mute just before I unplug it and crackle in your ears. All right, there we go. So I just found that a day or two ago, and I played with it yesterday, and I thought it was a neat thing to bring up and just do a little bit of a segment on. All right, that's all I wanted to show you in this short little segment. All right, that was BossJock. That's what I did this past weekend. I sat down here and on Saturday on my day off and decided to record that just to make an episode rather quickly because I was playing with it, kind of liked it. Just a couple of reminders before we end this episode. You can find us at tech-zen.tv 24 hours a day. You can find all of our shows there. We have, if you go to the show page, which is techzen.tv/newmediatech or newmediatech.tv, either one of those two would take you there. You can find contact information. You can send us an email, find us on Twitter, like our Facebook page. We love you if you do that kind of stuff. And just a few requests in that process is if you're watching us on YouTube, there is a thumbs up button down beneath the video that we appreciate, the thumbs up and the like there. And if you can want to write a comment, that's even better. And even better is if you hit that share button and send it to a couple of your friends to help us get the word around. If you're watching us on an iTunes download, can you just hop into iTunes real quick? Just write a comment about the show. All the comments and things like that and feedback helps us. Well, first of all, helps us know if we're doing things the way you want us to do it to give you the information that you need. But it also helps us get up in the rankings. And it's very hard on iTunes to show up in the rankings unless people help you out by creating comments in there. And if you're listening on Stitcher, which has been a weird show for Stitcher because it's kind of a visual show. But if you're listening on Stitcher, again, there give us a little bit of a bump because that helps us come up in the rankings and this helps us get found a little bit better. And you can get us on all kinds of different podcasting. We're on the Roku now. We're actually now also part of the Tech Podcast Network. That's something recent, so you can get us there. And they're also on the Roku. So we're like all over the place, and we're trying to expand that. but we need your help to get the word around. Just because we're there doesn't mean they come. That's the old saying about if you build it, they will come. It doesn't work. So, any help you can give us there is definitely appreciated. And we do put out a new show every week, and we'll see you in next week's show.